Hello students, so we discussed the connection of a biasing p-n junction diode and we draw its characteristics curve in reverse condition. In draw of a reverse connection, the characteristics curve, we take the voltage in x-axis and a current along y-axis in a reverse direction. Now, this is the x-axis and this is y-axis. X dash and y dash. Now this is the origin. Now we apply voltage in diagram. The negative is connected to positive, means holes are connected to negative and free electrons are connected to positive terminal of a battery. The negative voltage are applied, then we show in diagram or a graph in a negative direction. Suppose we increase the voltage in a negative direction, that is the minus voltage, and this is the reverse current. So y dash is referred as IR, means reverse current, and this x1 represents as Vf, that is the reverse, means negative Vf, that is the reverse voltage, means Vr. So Vf and this is the If. When we applied reverse voltage, now we applied this voltage to this junction, then we decide what happens at this junction. Now the junction resistance will be increased. So this previous class we study the junction resistance will be high. Practically there is no current passes through the junction, but when we increased further this voltage, then the minority charge carrier cannot flow to any direction or in the circuit, but we consider the minority charge carrier. So minority charge carrier of p material, that is the free electrons, and the minority charge carrier of n material, that is the holes. So this minority charge carrier are possible to move from one side to another side. So this current is a very low amount current because of the minority charge carrier are present in a very less amount. This momentum of charge particle due to minority charge carrier, this is the minority or reverse current, that is the leakage current. So this current will be very very less. Then when we start or when we apply any voltage, the reverse current, this is the reverse current direction. So suppose very less amount current is flowing when we applied a 5 volt, 10 volt, 15 volt, 20 volt, 25 volt, 30 volt, like this. When we apply some voltage, then reverse current will be flow, and then further we increase this reverse voltage at a point DHD, then a reverse current is rapidly flow. So this point is known as breakdown point. So this point is also known as a breakdown point. So this breakdown point is known as a breakdown voltage. So breakdown voltage is that voltage which in which the reverse current start to flow in rapidly. So a particular current or particular voltage is known as a reverse voltage or a breakdown voltage. After breakdown, the current, the reverse current will be rapidly flow in the circuit or through across the junction. So this reverse current is permanently damaged to the PN junction. So this action is, this curve is also known as a reverse characteristics curve. So this is the B and I. This curve is known as a reverse characteristics curve. So in a reverse condition, the reverse current will be flow in a reverse direction after the breakdown voltage. So this breakdown voltage or reverse current is damaged to the junction, then it will be not safe for a PN junction diode. So this is the two point we discussed one is breakdown voltage, and second one to knee voltage. So these two voltages we discussed in a forward and a reverse biasing or VI characteristic curve. So breakdown voltage, the breakdown voltage we can write the reverse voltage applied to PN junction, the reverse current start to flow at a particular reverse bias voltage. Now this thing, see, we discussed in a reverse bias. Then the breakdown voltage, this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. So this is the V of R means reverse voltage, and this is the reverse current. When we apply reverse bias in reverse direction, then this voltage, then increasing voltage, then further increasing. What happens? First, the reverse current, the reverse voltage apply, some leakage current means minimum current will be flow through the circuit. At a particular point, then the reverse current will be rises rapidly. A particular voltage, so the reverse current starts to flow at particular reverse bias voltage. The particular reverse bias voltage, that is the VR, is known as reverse voltage or a breakdown voltage. But knee voltage is considered as forward biasing of a diode or forward characteristic curve of a diode. Then knee voltage knee voltage the forward biased forward bias voltage applied to the PN junction in which the current starts to flowing through the circuit. This particular forward voltage is known as knee voltage. Knee voltage. So when forward biased condition, in forward bias condition, voltage taken x-axis, that is the voltage, and a current along y-axis, that is the current. This is the forward current IF, this is the forward voltage VF, this is the axis, and this is the origin. Now we start increasing the voltage. When first we apply this voltage, then it will be no current, but at a particular point, then a current will be flow rapidly. So this particular point is known as a knee voltage. This particular voltage is known as a knee voltage. Knee voltage. So before knee voltage, current not flowing across the junction, but after cross the knee voltage, then current will be rapidly or increasing, more current flowing through the circuit. So this is all about your characteristics curve of a PN junction diode. Then we discuss the application of a diode. Then we discuss application of a diode. Application of PN junction diode. So the main application the main application of PN junction diode, PN junction diode is rectifier. So the main application of a diode is a rectifier. Now a term is a rectifier. What is the rectifier? A rectifier is a process by conversion AC to DC. Now we have a AC supply and a required for a DC supply, then we rectify DC voltage from the AC voltage, or the main application is the rectifier. Now the definition of a rectifier, the process in which the conversion of AC into DC is known as rectifier. So the meaning is that when we require DC supply for functioning of any electronic devices or any electronic equipment, but we have a AC voltage or AC current, how we get a AC from DC from AC? Now we convert AC into DC by using a rectifier process. So rectifier is the process, that this process is a conversion of AC into DC. So this rectifier is also various types, mainly two types of rectifier. Then we write the rectifier, types of rectifier. We write mainly two types of rectifier, types of rectifier. First, half wave, rectifier. Second one is the full wave rectifier. So from these two process of rectifier, now we start a half wave rectifier. So this half wave rectifier, what is its circuit diagram and what work and what is its application, all are discussed in this class. So half wave rectifier is the rectifier when we designed by using a single diode. The half wave rectifier, this rectifier is designed with a single diode, When we use a single diode, then we will get a only half rectifier. Okay, now we draw a diagram of a half rectifier. First, our diagram of a half आपको एक रेक्टिफायर Now we see a single diode is connected in this circuit. So this is the supply voltage, input supply voltage, input supply, and this is a transformer. This is the transformer, transformer, and this is the diode. This is the load resistor. Now, in a transformer, so we apply AC input in primary side, then we get the required voltage, the required AC voltage from secondary side. Suppose we supply to 20 volt in AC. Then we require voltage. Suppose we get 0 12 volt. Suppose we get 12 volt AC from secondary side. This 12 volt AC converted into DC by using a single diode and a load resistor. So when we applying input supply, then it is transferred to the amount of voltage by the turn ratio. Then suppose 12 volt AC as are reached A and B, that is the terminal A and B. Suppose 12 volt AC supply to the diode. Now the AC supply contains two components, AC signal or AC input contain two component, that is the positive side and that is the negative side. When so this AC voltage are contain positive half and negative half. So this is the positive half, this is the negative half. Then this cycle is repeatedly changed in second 50 times. So in 1 second the cycle will be changed 50 times. So the frequency of our supply is 50 hertz. When this positive half cycle reach at the point A, at that particular time the negative half cycle reach at the point B. When A get positive half cycle, this positive half cycle are connected to anode point of a diode, that is the anode point, that is the cathode point. So when anode point get positive, then diode will be forward biased and it passes the half cycle. Then this half cycle reach at the anode point, then this diode will be forward bias and this half cycle will pass or passes across this PN junction diode, then we will get half cycle. After change this cycle, then it will be negative and at a point B it will be positive. So this positive are connected to cathode point and negative will be connected to anode point. Then the diode is in a reverse bias condition. In a reverse bias condition, the current cannot flow through the diode. So this positive half cycle of input supply only one half cross the junction, then we get a positive half cycle. Then after negative half cycle, reach at the anode, then it will be no passes through the current, then it will be taken some time. Then after cycle will be changed, then positive half cycle, then again positive half cycle, then negative, then positive, then negative, then positive, like this. So this waveform, is known as half wave rectifier waveform. This waveform is half wave rectifier waveform. So in a half wave rectifier, this positive half cycle from the input supply, we will get any output of rectifier, and in negative half cycle of input supply, get to the anode point, then it will reverse bias. It is not possible cross across the junction, then it will be not any output side. So we get only positive half cycle of input supply, then the output waveform is known as a half wave rectifier waveform. So this is the half wave rectifier. Now a new thing is that from this waveform, the positive half cycle, then it will be taken some time, then positive half cycle, then it is taken some time, the positive half cycle. So this negative half cycle, this negative half cycle from input to supply, it will be clipped up by this diode. This negative half cycle will be clipped up by this diode. So this waveform like this, then it is also known as a rectifier output. This is the DC. Again, another things. When the output of rectifier is known as a DC supply or a DC output, again the negative half cycle from input will be clipped up, but we consider that the current will be rises, or voltage or current will be rises 0 to some positive direction, or a maximum 0 to maximum, then it will be decreased. Next half cycle, the current will be rises from 0 to maximum, and then will be decreased. After that, then the current will be rises to maximum, then this current will be decreased. So in this way, first the current or charge particle rises to maximum, then decrease or touch to axis, then after rises to maximum, then reach to touch to axis. So in this nature is known as a up and down. So there is some disturbance are there. So this disturbancing nature, this disturbancing nature is also known as a pulsating DC. So it is DC, but in a pulsating DC, because of some pulses or some disturbance nature is in there. So when this pulsating DC or a AC the pulsating DC or in nature of AC is known as a repel. Is known as a repel. Repel. So this waveform first starting from 0 to maximum, then 0, then start maximum, then 0, then start to 0 to maximum, then 0. This also known as a repel. So repel are present in output side is known as a pulsating DC, that is not a pure DC. So in this section, this AC voltage converted into DC. So we first discussed now at first position, the input supply is transferred to output transferred to secondary of a transformer, then it will be AC. This AC contains two components, positive and negative. This positive and negative are reached. This is the positive half cycle reached at the anode point. At that particular time, the negative point are reached at the cathode point. So in this condition, the diode is the forward biased because of anode get positive and cathode get negative. In this condition, the diode will be forward biasing. Then in forward biasing, diode can conduct the current across this junction. So this is also known as a half wave rectifier. So in half wave rectifier, the half positive cycle from the input we get in RL. How it is possible? Then we discuss when a full complete cycle are reached at the PN junction diode. Suppose a positive half cycle reached at this junction. Now this is the positive half cycle reach the anode, then it will be allowed to pass. Then this voltage we will get at output section. This positive supply R goes to this the secondary terminal of the transformer by across the load resistor. So in this way, this is the complete circuit, then current will flow, then we get output voltage from the RL or load resistor. This is the Euro half wave rectifier designing of a PN junction diode.